shall give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, Hakwadash. Double honors the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone, who rule well. Peace and blessings to the sincere Akim, who are doing this work in truth and sincerity. I want to say Shalom. Lord willing, this is an edifying lesson. Just an update on Russia, World War III, and what's going down. It says Biden sent troops to Eastern Europe. So, Biden, he's pro-war, just like he was. Jim Crow Joe. He was, you know, pro-war under the Obama administration, pretty much his whole career, just like he is now, you know. That's what he is. He's pro-war. We're seeing Russia. Putin, he has his troops over there in Brussels. So Obama defense secretary, no question America lives at stake in Ukraine-Russia conflict. So this conflict, it's going to be one that really probably kicks it off. You know, so, you know, you can look at these things. You can go on whatever sites you go on. I go on Drudge Report. I go on Twitter. We can see these updates coming in. Okay, these live updates. You know, let's see. Russia. So, trying to see. So yeah. I believe Russia has their troops in Belarus. Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, Poland, Germany, all these places here, Bulgaria. So, we're going to see all these troops gearing up for what's getting ready to happen. Let's see, Brussels, Belgium. Yeah. So you have okay, that's over there by Germany, Netherlands, Poland. So yeah, you're gonna start seeing more and more of these conflicts go on. It's all prophesied in the scriptures. Ezekiel 38. And I started at 1. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against God, the land of Magog, the chief prince of Meshach, Tubal, and the prophesy against him. And say, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I am against thee, O Gog, the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal. So, Gog represents Russia, Edomites. Russians are Edomites. of the nation there are Edomites. Verse 4. I will turn thee back and put hooks into thy jaws, and I will bring thee forth and all thy army, horses, horsemen, and all the clothes, and all sorts of the armor, you and a great company with bucklers and shields, and all of them handling swords. Persia, Ethiopia, Libya, with them, all of them with shield and helmet, Gomer, and all his bands in the house of Togarmah, in the north quarters, and all his bands, and all the people with thee. Be thou prepared, and prepare for thyself, thou and all thy company that are assembled unto thee, and be a guard unto them. So Russia's being a guard to smaller nations who are there in league with, who are not in NATO and the EU. Okay? Because their military power is pretty large and they have a lot of power. So they're going to be a guard. Right? So Russia cannot bully, Babylon can't bully Russia, China, Iran, these other nations like they can do with smaller nations, you know? Because Esau will get in there, take down the leader, okay, infiltrate the country. He'll do all these things if he has to for their natural resources, mainly, okay, for that control. Revelation 20:8, and shall go out to deceive the nations which are in the four quarters of the earth, Gog and Magog, to gather them together to battle, the number of whom is as the sand of the sea. Verse 9, and they went up to the breadth of the earth, and compassed the camp of the saints about and below city. Fire came down from the God of the heaven and devoured them. So Esau, using his blessing and his sword, he's going to keep that blessing until the very end. And you see he's never stopped with his blessing. Russia just laid the trap to start Ukraine war. And America has to have that enemy. And now we see an enemy is Russia. They use Russia as a scapegoat for Donald Trump. They lied like they do and say that they interfere with the elections. So they're always lying on other countries, their own people. They're always in conflict with their own nation, seems like. You know, because they're both Edomites. You know? So it's all stage. Donald Trump says Ukraine, Russia crisis is a European problem. You know, who gives a shit what Donald Trump says? Because he's been exposed. He's nothing like how he portrayed himself to be. He's a shill, puppet, all right? Deceived all those people, you know. So we're going to see. Okay. Let's get this here. So, you know, pretty much other countries are going to join in as well. Join in on this skirmish or this conflict. This is the book of Job 3. Let's start at verse 9. Proclaim ye this among the Gentiles. Prepare war. Make up the mighty men. Let all the men of war draw near. Let them come up. You know, so there's going to be drafts in these different countries. There's going to be mandatory drafts to join the military. There's going to be drafts here in Babylon the Great. There's going to be, you know, women and men, young women are going to be forced into this draft, you know. Verse 10, beat your plowshares into swords and pruning hooks into spears, let the weak say I am strong. So, they're gathering all they have, and they're investing in their military, other than other things that they could invest in. They're focusing on the military aspect. Verse 11. Assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen, and gather yourselves together round about. Thither cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord. Let the heathen be awakened and come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat. For there will I sit to judge all the heathen and round about. So the heathen are going to be judged. Okay. Verse 13, put ye in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe. Come, get ye down, for the press is full, the fats overflow, for the wickedness is great. Verse 14, multitudes in the valley of decision, for the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. The sun and the moon shall be darkened, and the stars shall withdraw their shining. Yep, because the very last stage, intercontinental ballistic missiles are going to be in the air, shot off. Okay, simultaneously, the Lord's going to be in the sky as well. He's going to have chariots in the sky. He's going to be here to return. So it's going to all happen at that one. It's going to be that one big move. So Esau's going to fail miserably, and no one ever is going to come up in power when the kingdom of heaven is established. No other nation. So, Lord willing, that was edifying. Give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem Yahshai, Bashem Rakar Kadash. The wives of the apostles and elders, I greet Millstone. Who well? Shalom.